Hello learners, welcome to the D.El.Ed program. I am Dr. Vanita Anand and today we are going to discuss about using ICT as a resource for EVS teaching learning. What is ICT? ICT stands for Information and Communication Technology. It refers to all the technologies that provide access to information through telecommunications. It is similar to information technologies, but focuses primarily on communication technologies that include the internet, wireless networks, smart boards, cell phones, and other communication mediums. That is, not just getting the information, but also be in a position to communicate that information. Globalization and technological change processes over the last few years have created a completely new global economy, which is powered by technology, fueled by information, and driven by knowledge. Our classrooms have to keep pace with it. The classroom must also be powered by technology, fueled by information, and driven by knowledge. The National Policy of Education, 1986, emphasized that educational technology should play an important role in educational sector. All the policies after this particular policy reiterated the same. NCF 2005 talked about inclusion of ICT in the classrooms for the teaching learning process. What is the need of ICT? Information age. Today, we are living in information age. There is information explosion. This provides numerous opportunities. Rather, the opportunities that are there are unprecedented. Previously, they could not even be thought about, but they are the reality now. ICT teaches skills and knowledge, not only to the students, also to the teacher. It bridges the existing technology gap in teaching and learning process. Technology gap. There are a number of students who are using ICT and technology on day-to-day basis, whereas there are certain sections of society and certain kinds of schools in the interiors of our country where they are not even aware. Now, with the help of ICT, this gap intends to be bridged. That is, ICT is cost-effective. The government is making sure that it reaches every nook and corner of the country so that the technology gap is lessened and subsequently reduced and finished. Enhancement of student achievement. As everything is available to the students all the time, and lifelong learning is what has been made possible because of ICT, the student achievement, the student knowledge, everything is enhanced. Enhances teachers' pedagogical practices. For a teacher, it has given lots of opportunity and lots of ways to enrich the pedagogical practices. ICT is most crucial resource for education, especially in today's time. There are a number of factors. What makes it that much important? Children these days are tech savvy. They are extremely comfortable with all the modern gadgets, be it computers, laptops, iPads, tablets, etc. And they are very comfortable in learning with the help of these gadgets. Smart boards are there in most of the classrooms these days. Moreover, there are assistive technologies which are intended to assist special needs students. Now, assistive technologies are any kind of devices and ICT technologies that caters to the needs of children with special needs. There are a number of assistive technologies available. For example, there are timers, there are speech-to-text and text-to-speech technologies, there are multi-language keyboards, etc. ICT and the teacher. For the teacher, it is extremely beneficial, because it helps the teacher to explore educational possibilities of technology. And there are limitless possibilities. Learning to make right choices of hardware, software, and ICT interactions to make teaching learning process a more fruitful endeavor. Now, the teacher has a lots of things to choose from so that proper software and ICT interactions are used which suit the given content and also the needs and interests of the students in her classroom. Growing to become a critical user of ICT, there are a number of things that are available on the websites, on the net, and various kinds of online courses are available. It is the responsibility of the teacher to decide what is best for the students, and hence, in the process, the teacher becomes a critical user of ICT. ICT and the student. For the student, it is the initiation into creativity and problem solving. This the student is doing on his or her own. The student is becoming creative. All the information is there. What to draw from that information and how to solve the problems of day-to-day life and related to the content, it is entirely upon the student to take help from whatever the ICT has to offer. An introduction to the world of information and technologies. This can be done right from the beginning. Students should be made aware of the ICT and whatever is available for them. An opportunity to learn in a variety of ways. There can be videos, there can be audios, there are a number of online objects that are there that the students can use, and they must learn how to use them to the best of their benefit. Technology assists students in a number of ways. Learn by doing. Now, the students are doing by themselves. What are they doing? They can do anything that they want to. They can make projects, they can do simulations, they can go to any website and get any kind of information that they want. Receive feedback. There are various web objects and number of online games which give instant feedback to the student. Rather, they do not let the student proceed until they have mastered the previous level of learning. Refine understanding. To understand the given concept, if the student is having problem at any given area, he or she may go to the related sites to find the related information. Build new knowledge. In the endeavor to get the knowledge, there are a number of things that a student finds out, not just about the content, but also about technology and its benefits. Visualize difficult concepts. The things that were previously difficult to understand, or the objects which were difficult to visualize, for example, life in space, the students can visualize these difficult concepts with the help of ICT. Access extensive collection of information. Every kind of information, be it in the form of websites, images, videos, news reports, everything is available and it is open for all to use. Solve real world problems. There are number of games and technologies and number of applications that help the student with certain problems. They can have a problem and find their own solutions. Test those solutions one by one and find the best solution. Engage an active environment for learning. Now, when the student is using ICT, the student has to remain active. So, these are active kind of learning. Thus, it is child-centered. An ICT-enabled classroom is always knowledge-rich because everything is available. It is upon students and teachers to make the best use of whatever ICT has to offer. Learner-centered, learner is active and engaged throughout, not only with the help of his senses, but also mentally. That is why it is a learner-centered approach and not just teacher-centered. It is connected to real life because it gives lots of scope where the student can actually apply this knowledge with the help of ICT to see how the solutions help him in the real life. A comparison between traditional and ICT-enabled classroom. First of all, let us see how a classroom looks like. In the traditional classroom, the classroom is physical. It is limited to just four walls that are there in the classroom. However, ICT-enabled classroom is boundaryless. It is not just the four walls that the teacher and the student are operating in. It is unlimited. It offers anytime and anywhere kind of learning. Content in the traditional classroom, textbook, classroom library, PPT presentation, transparencies, or at best, audios and videos are utilized. However, in ICT-enabled classroom, there are digital libraries, online content, simulations, multimedia, online objects, everything is available. And with the help of digital library, the subscriptions can be taken and the libraries anywhere around the world can be accessed. Personalization. In traditional classroom, there is just one learning path. There is just one learning that is taking place. It has to suit all the students, whether it actually suits or not. Whereas in the ICT-enabled classroom, there is flexibility in terms of content, in terms of material aids, in terms of ICT aids that caters to the needs of all children, not just children with multiple intelligences, but also special children, that is the children with special needs, because to help them, there are a number of assistive technologies that are present. Advantages to EVS teacher: to enhance the initial preparation by giving good teaching material. Once the teacher has prepared whatever inputs she wants to give to the classroom, there is everything ICT has to offer that the teacher needs. To have access with colleagues, institutions, universities, and national organizations like NIOS, SCERT, UGC, NCERT, NCTE, and NAC, and so on. So there is an immediate access with the help of the chat rooms and emails, etc. To interact with students over a physical distance. Again, this can be immediate or it can be with the help of emails, etc. To access online libraries, journals, and researchers to enable individual learning. Now, the teacher can make sure that there is individualized learning and there is something for everybody. To share resources with the teachers across the globe. There are different groups that are made by the teachers where they can share their resources, lesson plans, ICT aids, etc. To use online courses for the benefit of teachers as well as students. A number of online courses are available differently for teachers as well as for the students, and they should be used by both the sections. To use simulation apps and game-based learning in the classroom. In the simulation apps, the things which cannot be done otherwise can be done here without any kind of danger. The teacher must make good use of these simulation apps. Likewise, there are a number of game-based apps which cater to the educational needs of the classroom. For example, there are crosswords, quizzes, and so on. To use assistive technologies for the children with special needs. The teacher herself should be aware of these assistive technologies so that she can let the students in her classroom, the students who are with special needs, so that they can be benefited from the assistive technologies based on ICT that are available. Easy to track students' progress. The teacher can keep an online record of the students' progress, and the progress is presented grammatically or graphically with the help of the number of tools that are given by the ICT, for example, graphs, etc. Role of ICT. ICT encourages every pupil to be active. That is why it is learner-centered approach. No matter what is the level of the student, the ICT offers something to everybody, and that is why all the pupils in the given classroom remain active. Have a deeper understanding of concepts. Wherever the student needs to get more understanding of the concepts, he or she may go to the related pages, to the related websites, to the textbooks, libraries, and so on. Repeatable. If the student feels the need that he needs to repeat whatever has been done, it can be done anytime and anywhere, not just in the classroom. Opening new horizons about learning opportunities and consequently interest. There are unlimited opportunities that ICT offers for learning, and it is in consonance with the interests of the students. Inculcates habit of lifelong learning. Lifelong learning is very important, as the technology is in the hands of the child, and for that matter, in the hands of everybody, it is important that a habit of lifelong learning is inculcated, as a number of changes take place in the given subject from time to time. A teacher, as well as the student, must be aware of them, and that is possible only if they have a habit of lifelong learning. Enables students to work independently and constructively. Students all the time do not remain dependent on the help of the teacher. There is technology that is there with them all the time. The teacher must make the students empowered to use this technology constructively and independently. ICT in teaching learning enhances teaching and learning environments in the classroom, enables self-paced learning through various tools. There is not just one way that would operate in the classroom or otherwise. It is self-paced. The pace of one student may differ from the other. And there are these tools which would cater to the individualized needs. They can proceed at their own pace. Teaching learning enterprise becomes more productive and meaningful. For this, the student must be empowered to use the right websites, to use the best applications that are available, so that whatever learning is taking place is meaningful and productive. Here, not only learning, even the teaching has to be productive, meaningful, and no time and effort should be wasted. Keeps the students updated. In fact, ICT keeps students as well as teachers updated. There are certain subjects which keep on changing from time to time. For example, social sciences, EVS. It is very important for the teacher to know what latest changes have come in their subject so that she can tell it to the students. Now, ICT makes it possible for the teacher to keep updated with all the latest that is taking place in EVS. The students, by being self-sufficient and independent with the help of ICT, can also make themselves updated. Fosters a live contact between teacher and student through email, e-learning, web-based learning, AVAs, etc. Now, this can also be done with the help of chat rooms, audio-video conferencing, that can be one way as well as two way. They can have contact with the teacher and the experts in any corner of the world. ICT is seen as tools to help teachers create more learner-centered learning environments. The learning environments that the teacher tries to create in the classroom should be learner-centered. And these days, learners learn the best when ICT technologies are used in the classroom, as it keeps most of their senses active. Many teachers use ICT to support traditional learning methods. ICT just doesn't support the constructivist approaches. It may also suit the traditional learning methods. For example, if the teacher is using the traditional learning methods, even then ICT can be beneficial. For example, for information retrieval, for teaching methods, for presenting information, and even for the purpose of assessment. ICTs can be used to support change and to support and extend existing teaching practices. Engage students more actively to produce knowledge. Knowledge which is fruitful. The students are engaged with the help of ICT. They use number of applications. They have to give inputs. They have to think. They have to hypothesize. That ensures that students are engaged mentally throughout the conceptualization of the concepts. ICT tools. There are a number of ICT tools that can be made use of in the classroom. PCs, laptops, tablets, CD-ROMs, DVD, digital videos, still cameras, internet and related tools like www, email, web objects, etc., computer-aided instruction, email and chat rooms, one-way and two-way audio and video conferencing, e-books, Kindle, e-library, e-newsletters, and e-brochures, etc. In fact, there are limitless possibilities as far as ICT tools are concerned. Benefits: it is time-saving and less expensive. With the help of ICT, lots of time is saved because everything is ready-made. There are a number of videos that are available that a good teacher must try to make use of. And it is not at all expensive. It is very, very cost-effective. There are just a few things that are required, and the students can make good use of ICT in the classroom. It provides interactive learning experiences. As we talked about ICT, where communication is very important, so through emails, through chat rooms, two-way audio-video conferencing, the learning experiences become interactive. There is sharing, there is discussion, and so on. Stimulates and motivates student learning. The students remain motivated throughout. Caters to different learning styles. Whatever is the learning style of the student, it caters to the needs of all. Aids in understanding tough concepts. No matter how tough the concept is, there are a number of aids that help to make the concept easy and step by step for the child. Suits collaboration and group tasks, promotes creativity, provides variety as well as flexibility in learning because the student can go at his own pace. ICT in EVS, it can be used for lesson planning, for enriching content transaction, for activity-based learning, creating assignments, creating worksheets which can be individualized, for the record keeping. Record keeping can be of students' grades, results, achievement, and for assessment. ICT-enabled classroom in practice. Set the rules for using ICT equipment in the classroom right in the beginning. Form groups and assign them activities. Provide handouts. Use audios and videos. Use word processor, spreadsheets, and PowerPoint. Utilize interactive whiteboard. Use educational games. You can also use assistive technologies if there are students with the special needs. Let them learn independently. Allow them to search independently, but guide them in research and gathering information. Let them relate new knowledge with the previous experiences. Encourage them to solve problems. Help them to draw conclusions. Scope of ICT in EVS. Various cultures can be taught. Farming practices. Important personalities, layers of earth, life in space, flora and fauna, environment, and so on. In fact, every aspect of study in EVS has a scope of ICT. In the end, we can sum up by saying, ICT provides unlimited opportunities to the teacher as well as the taught. It raises quality of learning. It attempts to lessen the digital divide. ICT tool rather cater to all learning needs. Thank you so much.